How do you choose when you put on the camera?
I think that there's a fundamental flaw in the way that our society views happiness. And I'm going to use this question posed by my new friend Jazz, whom I've only known for the past 12 hours, to show you what I mean.
How long has it been?
What?
Since we've been out like this.
Uh-huh.
For a walk.
This is my friend and one of my roommates, Tony.
It's an easy task, I think, you handsome devil.
Tony is the enabler of the story because, well, Jakob says it best.
The activation energy for Tony to start talking to someone he's never met before is virtually zero, and I'm really jealous of that. It's cool.
It is very impressive.
Makes him very good flirting.
Oh, fuck! Damn,
this is awesome.
Who is that?
A new friend.
Tony's new friend here is Jess. Yeah, this Jazz. She and her friend Lynn were visiting from Amsterdam this weekend.
Did you approach her or did she approach you?
I approached her.
Cute.
We're just all gonna grab drinks tonight because we're leaving tomorrow.
You're actually, I could be down.
Yeah.
I saw her when I walked by, so she also saw me and did a cute little smile.
Yeah, I see someone and then if I have this weird sense of familiarity, of like where there's some warmth in their look, and I don't let go of that thought for a while, then I just approach them.
I love everything about this.
Because I need to get better at doing that again. I really still feel like I kind of lost it a little bit during COVID and I haven't really gotten it back yet.
I asked Tony what his opening line was.
What was it? It's very simple. I just asked her, hey, would you like to grab a coffee sometimes?
Ah, cool. Yeah, it works well.
It's always about the how. We all met Jazz and Lynn that night for drinks and shared stories and ideas. Our chats were so incredible that we invited them for brunch the following morning before their train back to Amsterdam.
Very progressive too, I think, compared to...
That's it?
Mm-hmm. These girls are the definition of cool.
Hello.
Hello.
Cute. It's just very nice that like we met in Berlin and now like I'm visiting you in Amsterdam.
It is nice.
Jazz is a movement artist and Lynn is a spoken word artist. Two extremely reflective creatives who ask really good questions.
I remember like looking at you at that moment and you guys were just like in awe.
Yeah.
In a way.
Like the table? Sure. Mm-hmm. You know, like making the food also? Sure.
Sure.
Got that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Chairs? Sure.
But creating
the carpet?
A full...
Creating a full living room outside and we were just on the roof.
How do you choose when you put on the camera? Or how do you decide?
I think it depends. I'm quite, I think, conversation driven most of the time. Mm. If there are things that, like, if I see a conversation going in like that, cool place, sometimes I put on the camera and just kind of forget about it for a bit. But that always ends up with a lot of footage.
Yeah. Do you watch everything back? Or are there also like...
There are things I don't watch back. But I know what the conversations were, and I can come back to them if I'm making a video. But then I always get lost in like, wow, that was a cool day. Like, I want to like rewatch this like thing. And it's just nice because a lot of it is just like stuff, you know, like you just forget you have. Yeah. But when you have the footage, you just relive it, you know?
And it really feels like a movie when you shoot it on these cameras as well.
Mm-hmm.
Like you just rewatch and you're like, my life's a fucking movie.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it is a little bit romanticizing. Yeah.
It's literally a movie, yeah.
Yeah, it's funny because like I always like worry, am I not doing enough? Like, blah, 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 blah. Then I'm always like enjoying these moments and all, especially like living in this flat and like with these people. But I think finally it's just about being happy, you know? However you define your happiness.
Would you say you're happy now?
I mean like this. How can you not be? Yeah.
You can be.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I think that the community here and the people that we've collected, it's just like what makes, I think, me very happy. It's just like everyday life, on like a day-to-day basis, there's so much happiness is so much like that you're experiencing with like really great people that just make me genuinely very happy.
I love that answer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's a good answer. I think there's an interesting distinction that I don't think you've really touched on much in this whole conversation about the difference between happiness and like contentedness or satisfaction. Mm-hmm. And the way I see it is one is short-term, one is long-term. Like happy is like a short-term state that you achieve in like good moments, good days, you know? But contentedness or satisfaction is what you achieve by stringing together enough moments of happiness over time.
Our society puts very unrealistic pressure on individuals to be happy all the time. Why I document and why I turned on the camera at that moment was because I genuinely felt happiness that I wanted to remember. In 50 years, I want to look back at these videos and remember how it felt to be sitting with these two new friends, having meaningful conversations. I want to remember what life was like when I was in my late 20s living with my best friends in Berlin, because none of this is permanent. I want to remember all these happy moments so that when I'm older, just like now, I feel content and satisfied with a well-lived, meaningful life, filled with beautiful connections.
She did ask really
good. Should I kiss her? I don't know. Maybe not.
Keep it for next time you're in Amsterdam.
Maybe.
You can miss her.
Yeah.